What's up guys, Philip here with Molly. 1.5 years ago, I sat on this very spot talking about the best ways to activate your dog. And not much has changed when it comes to that topic. Every dog still has a certain need of being activated. They need to stimulate their mind as much as they need to stimulate their body. But in winter time, the creativity and the motivation for us dog owners might be a bit limited. But you know, guess what? Your dog will need to be activated no matter of the season. So today we're going to talk about the best ways to activate your dog. Winter edition. All right, let's get into it and start with tracking. In one way or another, I do this basically every day with my dog. It's such a good exercise because your dog won't just be stimulated physically. They will be stimulated mentally by the search itself. While your dog is running, your dog's brain will go in 100 miles per hour to filter out different scents to be able to find the right scent. It's so effective that only 15 to 30 minutes will give you a very happy and a satisfied dog. Now, some might argue that it's not good to track during winter time, and I would argue against it. I'd say summertime is more convenient for us dog owners, but the snow gives us the chance to choose how difficult we want the tracking to be. If you have a dog that's not used to tracking, you could just go a few meters and hide whatever that you're hiding in open sight. But you could also walk a longer route and throw whatever that you're hiding away from you to make it more of a challenge for your dog. You can even hide it under the snow. Now, just to be clear, whether it's a stick, a toy or trees that you're hiding, all depends on what your dog is interested in. As you see, right now I'm hiding treats in the snow, which also is a good way to complicate things, and it's real easy. And of course, if it's a storm outside or if you're feeling unwell, you could always hide treats inside your house. So as you see, there's always a way to activate your dog. Drag weight. There's always occasions more or less where you have to walk with your dog on a leash. In big cities, that's almost the only thing you can do, except of a few occasions where you might bring your dog to a park or a small forest. This is why drag weight is such a good exercise. Even though your dog is on a leash, they will be stimulated both physically and mentally. While your dog is pulling the weights, he or she can smell the scent that's in front of them, exactly like a regular walk on a leash, but you know, more effective. Just remember not having too much weight behind your dog. It's not a race about whose dog can pull the most, it's about stimulating your dog and making them feel good. I would say that 5 to 10% is a good start and not more than 3 times a week. And just to be clear, running is not allowed in this exercise. That can actually damage your dog. Just imagine yourself doing squats or deadlifts with no technique at all, you know, that won't be good. Also, if you notice that your dog don't want to continue walking, just remove the weights. Don't push your dog above the limits. Running. Here you obviously have a lot of possibilities. What I really enjoy doing is grabbing my skis and just go down to the frozen river. Even though my dog isn't a typical breed for this exercise, she's loving it and so do I.
Where did you get back your energy from, huh?
I'm not even doing anything.
Now I understand that the typical dog owner won't be able to do this every day. But there's so many other ways to get your dog to run. Make a trail and get your dog to track it. Throw toys, sticks or snowballs, or just let your dog loose in a controlled area. Once again, some might argue that it's tough during winter time, and once again, I would argue against it. I mentioned in the video before that when your dog is chasing stuff that you're throwing, make sure to be careful with downhill exercises and fast breaks and stops. If you're throwing a ball, it's a high risk that your dog's joints will be damaged. In the winter, however, the snow removes that risk. Good luck twisting an ankle while running in a meter snow with a tenth of your normal speed. So that's another great thing about the winter. I can throw toys and sticks wherever I want, and what's even better, my dog has to work for every step that she takes. She will be quite tired when it's time for bed. And of course, it's quite convenient that I can pick up snowballs wherever I am, so I don't even have to bring toys to my walks anymore. Now, just to be clear, Molly here is a high energy working dog, so she loves to go all into these exercises. I wouldn't, however, bring Vilde here to that level. She will be fine with a little bit of tracking, a little bit of running in the snow, and then she's good. I'm saying this just to be clear that this level of energy isn't for every dog. Your dog does not have to cope with my dog's intensity and love of working. The principle of doing activities like this is, however, for every dog, and yours included. You just need to be responsible and choose the right level of intensity when activating your dog. Obedience and practicing tricks. If you've been following this channel, you know that I really enjoy practicing tricks and activating my dogs with obedience training. When a dog is focused, a lot of energy is used. They will try their best to figure out how they can get that reward. Never underestimate the power of sit, down, stay, spin around, heal, and so on. Now, the mental stimulation that they do get isn't the only reason why I train obedience with my dogs. First of all, I love interacting with my dogs, and what's better than working together as a team towards the same goal? Another thing that's awesome with obedience training is the special connection you get with your dog. I do get questions from some of you about just that. How I got Molly to have that super focus on me, even though there's a thousand of other things in our surrounding that could break it. Another question that I also get quite frequently that has the same answer is how I got Molly so obedient and willing to work. Doing stuff like this the right way is the answer. I'm not a tyrannical leader to my dog, I'm a leader that she wants to be with. A leader that she trusts and wants to listen to. She associates me with positive and happy emotions. So every time she do what I ask, she has a blast. Her reward will either be a treat, tug of war, vocal encouragement, or just a physical touch. So every time we are working together, our bond is strengthened even more. Plus of the fact that she got a little bit more obedient and, of course, stimulated mentally so she won't destroy my house when it's time for bed.